You have a mom and a dad and maybe a few siblings. You are different, maybe very different from everyone else in your family. What would you and your siblings look like if you came from only a mother with no father? Would you look just like your mom? Just like your siblings? Would you all be a family of identical daughters? Or would you and your siblings all be different from your mom and different from one another? Could you even be a boy? To answer questions like these, we have to know more about how eggs are formed by the process of oogenesis, which occurs in the ovaries of a female. In the ovaries of a female, diploid oogonia divide by mitosis to produce more oogonia and specialized primary oocytes, still diploid, that are committed to producing eggs. The egg may then be fertilized by a sperm to produce an offspring. This is how offspring are usually produced. Parthenogenesis is a form of reproduction in which an egg develops into a new individual without being fertilized by a sperm. Let's examine normal oogenesis more closely before considering reproduction through parthenogenesis. In normal oogenesis, the diploid primary oocyte divides by meiosis to produce haploid daughter cells. Let's follow this process for a cell with 2n equals 4 chromosomes. Remember that each homologous pair of chromosomes consists of one paternal and one maternal chromosome. These chromosomes carry the same genes in the same sequence, but may carry different alleles. Each chromosome has been replicated in the S phase of interphase, and now consists of two identical sister chromatids joined at the centromere. During prophase 1 of meiosis 1, the chromosomes condense, become visible, and homologous chromosomes are paired up in synapsis. Crossing over occurs as non-sister chromatids on homologous chromosomes exchange genetic information. With crossing over, a chromosome is no longer fully maternal or fully paternal, but rather a mixture of maternal and paternal alleles. In metaphase 1, the paired chromosomes line up along the cell's equatorial plane. Pairs of homologous chromosomes line up randomly with either member of the pair oriented to one pole or the other. The pairs also orient randomly relative to other pairs in the process of independent assortment. In anaphase 1, the chromosomes in each homologous pair are separated from each other and pulled to opposite poles. In telophase 1, one haploid set of chromosomes is present at each pole. The cell divides by cytokinesis to produce two cells, a large haploid daughter cell called a secondary oocyte, and a tiny polar body with a haploid nucleus and very little cytoplasm. Meiosis II is very similar to mitosis, the type of cell division that occurs in somatic cells. The meiosis I products divide in meiosis II to produce two daughter cells, one of which becomes the egg. Remember, the meiosis I products are haploid, and so are its daughter cells. Meiosis II starts with prophase II as the chromosomes condense. In metaphase 2, the chromosomes move to the center of the cell and line up along the equatorial plane. In anaphase 2, the chromatids making up a chromosome are separated from each other and pulled to opposite poles. During telophase 2 and cytokinesis, the cell divides to produce two haploid daughter cells, a large egg and a tiny polar body. We will now discuss four ways that this process can be altered to produce parthenogenetic offspring. Mitotic division of the primary oocyte. Combination of the primary polar body with the secondary oocyte. Combination of the egg with the secondary polar body. The haploid egg divides by mitosis instead of fusing with sperm. Imagine that a female reproduces by parthenogenesis without undergoing meiosis, as primary oocytes develop directly into offspring by mitosis instead. Will the parthenogenetic offspring be genetically identical to their mom or genetically different? Will the offspring be genetically identical to one another or genetically different? Will the offspring be male or female? Imagine that the two haploid cells produced by meiosis 1, the secondary oocyte in the polar body, fuse back together to yield a diploid cell, and that this new cell develops into an offspring by parthenogenesis. Will the parthenogenetic offspring be genetically identical to their mom, or genetically different? Will the offspring be genetically identical to one another, or genetically different? Will the offspring be male or female? Imagine that the egg and the polar body produced at the end of meiosis 2 fuse to yield a diploid cell, and that this new cell develops into an offspring by parthenogenesis. Will the parthenogenetic offspring be genetically identical to their mom, or genetically different? Will the offspring be genetically identical to one another, or genetically different? Will the offspring be male or female? Usually, a haploid sperm fertilizes the haploid egg to produce a diploid zygote, which develops into an offspring. What if, instead of fusing with a sperm, the haploid egg divides by mitosis? For this to occur, chromosomes have to be replicated. During the S phase of interphase, the DNA of the single chromatid making up each chromosome in the developing egg is replicated. The chromosomes now consist of two identical sister chromatids joined at the centromere. Remember that each chromosome is a product of crossing over and comprises a combination of maternal and paternal genes. During mitosis, the replicated chromosomes line up along the equatorial plane at the center of the cell. The sister chromatids are pulled apart from each other to opposite poles as individual chromosomes. But instead of completing mitosis and cytokinesis, the new chromosomes stay in a single cell. Each chromatid now becomes an individual chromosome as they separate from each other, so the cell is now diploid. Imagine that this diploid cell develops into an offspring. This is another form of parthenogenesis because, again, an unfertilized egg is developing into an offspring. Will the parthenogenetic offspring be genetically identical to their mom, or genetically different? Will the offspring be genetically identical to one another, or genetically different? Will the offspring be male or female? So, there are four different ways for parthenogenesis to take place to produce an offspring from a mom with no dad. Many animals develop this way, and some of them may surprise you. Stay tuned!